going to start with chapter 3, democracy and diversity. In the previous session, we had discussed about chapter 2, federalism. Today we are going to learn in this session chapter 3, democracy and diversity. The topics are democracy, social division, social differences, social inequalities, social diversity, US civil movements, followed with assignments related to this session, chapter 3. Democracy. From class 6 onwards, we are reading about what is democracy. The general definition of democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. According to Abraham Lincoln, democracy is a government of the people, by the people, and for the people. This gives us a clear definition that democracy revolves around the people. People is the principal force driving towards democracy as a government. Now, democracy is based on two principles, liberty and equality. There are two elements of democracy, which is very important, election and public opinion. Due to political competitions in a democracy, social divisions get reflected in politics. Throughout the world, democracy is existing in many of the countries of the world. More than half the countries of the world are democracy. More than half the countries of the world are democracy. And in many democracies, there exist the differences of the people in regard to religion, language, culture. In a democracy, it is possible for communities to voice their grievances in a peaceful manner. Democracy is the best way to accommodate social diversity. In this chapter, we would read about democracy of the other countries of the world, and mostly we will focus with the examples from Indian democracy. There are two types of democracy, direct democracy and representative democracy or indirect democracy. Direct democracy is a system in which the people hold sovereignty and make decisions directly. Example of this is Panchayati Raj system that exists in village. A representative democracy and indirect democracy, where sovereignty is held by representatives elected by the people. This is common in a country having a large population. For example, India. India is a representative democracy. Here, the representative of the people hold power in a government. Society and its types. What is society? A society is a group of people living within defined territorial boundaries and sharing common culture. A society that has similar kind of people, especially where there are no significant ethnic differences, is known as homogeneous society. Example, Germany and Sweden. And contrary to this is a society that has different kinds of people from various regions of the world, which is basically a society that is ethnically heterogeneous. heterogeneity in terms of faith or belief system. Now coming to the social diversity. Diversity refers to the differences existing in a society. You can see a picture over here. What you can identify? You can identify the people different in their dress as well as their religion. This is visible in this. Throughout the world, you can find the differences existing in the people. You can also see the difference between their skin color. That is called racial discrimination. A successful community is one in which individuals of different race, ethnicity, religious beliefs, socio-economic status, language, geographical origin, gender or sexual orientation bring their different knowledge, background, experience and interest for the benefit of their diverse community. Example, India. India is a country having a diverse community living together. Now, social diversity is a feature of a society which is determined by caste, class, religion, occupational pattern in a given territory. Example, India is a caste-based society as well as class-based society and religious society. Caste difference exists in the form of Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. Class difference between the rich and the poor. Religious difference between the Hindus, Muslim, Sikh, Christians, Buddhist as well. Now, occupational pattern, depending upon the differences in the caste, earlier in the ancient India, the occupation of the people were decided in a given territory. In the social sphere, the general customs and manners of the people greatly differ. People of different regions use different types of dresses. Their eating habits, customs differ. Certain people are quite civilized while others are very backward in their customs. In short, India is a museum of cults and customs, creeds and cultures, faith and tongues, racial types and social systems. So India is a correct example of a country having a diverse culture people living together. Now coming to the another topic, social differences and its origin. You might have a question arising in your mind. Who have created these differences in the society? Where from this differences had its root? So social differences are the situations where people are discriminated against on the basis of social, economic and racial equality. Many social differences are generally based on accident of birth. Normally, we do not choose to belong to our community. We belong to it simply because we are born into it. People around us are male or female. They are tall or short, have different complexions or have different physical abilities or disabilities. Social differences are based on our choice. For example, some people are atheists. They do not believe in God or any religion. Some choose to follow religion other than in which they were born. So this is very much clear that social differences are all that is created by the society and people living in the society, depending upon their birth, depending upon their belief, depending upon the norms set by the society. Social differences are not made by the God. It is not created by the God. It is the choice of the people living in a society to choose the differences or to make the differences or to see the differences amongst us. Now, social differences and its origin. Most of us choose what to study, which occupation to take up, and which games to play, or which cultural activities to take part in. For example, when you are born in a family, you are born as a kid of that particular family, and you have your identity attached to that particular family itself. When you grew up, you joined your school, your identity is also associated with the school as well as the class in which you are placed in. Furthermore, after completing your studies, which occupation you will enter into, that adds another identity of you as an individual living in a society. All these lead to formation of groups that are based on our choice. All social differences do not lead to divisions. Social division of some or the other kind do exist in every society of the world and are reflected in politics. In democracy, it is natural that political parties talk of these divisions, make different promises to different communities, look after due representation of various communities, and make policies to redress the grievances of the disadvantaged, that means the backward communities. Social differences can be easily accommodated with some reservation policy. This means that social differences becomes division only when it is expressed in politics. Further, we will proceed with this, that how politics affect the differences in the society and make it division. Now we are moving towards another type of differences, that is overlapping and cross-cutting differences. What is overlapping difference? Overlapping of social difference happens when people of one out of two communities are not only discriminated but are also poor, and they begin to feel as they belong to the different community. Example, the caste discrimination that is existing in India. In the caste ladder, the untouchables, the Dalits, were at the lowest rung in a society. They are the discriminated as well as poor and distressed in the society. They are alienated from the mainstream of the society. They are forced to live in the outskirts of the society and follow all the norms set by the society, and were never treated equally. The same features can be found in the racist regime that is existing in America. In America, the racial discrimination, the black people that exist over there were discriminated in the same way as the Dalits in India. They were also poor, distressed, and deprived in the society. So we are talking of two differences of two different countries, of two different democracies of the world, but the features are the same. This is called overlapping of social differences. Now, cross-cutting differences happens when people are facing same issue but have different opinions about the way to resolve it. In this, discrimination often does not take place and problems could be solved peacefully. Cross-cutting differences are the differences which takes place when one kind of difference appears to be different in its features and its belief in different places. Overlapping differences and cross-cutting differences. The social differences overlap other social differences. Social differences cut one another. One social difference is reinforced by another social difference. And cross-cutting difference, one social difference is not reinforced by another social difference. Third one, it may result in deep social division, disintegration, and conflict. Cross-cutting difference promotes unity, encourages diversity, and it is easier to accommodate. Example of overlapping difference between the dark people and the white people, the racial difference becomes a social division in the US, as people with dark complexion usually stay unemployed, poor, homeless due to their skin color. Cross-cutting difference, in this kind of difference, the groups may share a common interest on an issue, even being on different sides on another issue. Example, Northern Ireland and Netherlands both are mainly Christian but divided between Catholics and Protestants. Similarly, in India, Dalits are usually ignored by the upper caste and they tend to be poor, homeless, landless, etc. So this is the clear difference between the overlapping difference and the cross-cutting differences. Now coming to the outcome of this, social groups of Netherlands, North Ireland. In Netherlands, class and region tend to cut across each other, leading to cross-cutting social differences. Catholics and Protestants are about likely to be rich or poor equally. These have no conflict in Netherlands, as cross-cutting social differences are easier to see in the society. In Northern Ireland, the population is divided into two major sects of Christianity. 53% are Protestant, 44% are Roman Catholics. The Catholics are more likely to be poor. They have suffered a history of discrimination. The Protestants are very rich. This results in conflicts between the Catholics and Protestants. Thus, class and religion overlap with each other in Northern Ireland. So this is called cross-cutting social difference. That means one difference cuts the another difference in a country. Social inequality. Social division takes place when some social difference overlaps with one another. The difference between the blacks and whites becomes a social difference in the US because the blacks tends to be poor, homeless, and discriminated against. This draws a clear demarcation or line between the two different communities. Situation of this kind produces social division when one kind of social difference becomes more important than the other, and people start feeling that they belong to different communities. So this is very difficult to be reconciled. Now, equality and equity, you can see in the figure. Equality, it talks about the same platform for all, whereas equity, depending upon the people and their rights, that is recognized. Now coming to the social division. Social divisions means division of society on the basis of social differences like language, region, caste, color, race, sex. Social division sometimes leads to political division of the country. Some social differences may result in social division. Some social divisions of one kind or the other exist in most countries of the world. Parties try to win political support by appealing to social divisions. All political expressions of social divisions need not be always dangerous. So because of the social division and diversities existing in a society, political parties sometimes makes the use of these differences in their favor to muster the support or to gather the support of the people of one particular group in a society in their favor. So this leads sometimes to social division as resulting in the political division as well. Social division of one kind or another exists in most countries because most countries of the world, whether big or small, are multicultural. India is a large country with many communities. Belgium is a small country with many communities. Even those countries such as Germany, Sweden, that were once highly homogeneous, are undergoing rapid change with influx of people from other parts of the world. Migrants bring with them their own culture and tend to form a different social community. In this way, most of the countries are multicultural in today's world. Now, we are trying to understand some other types of social division that exist in a society. Racial, the example of two Afro-Americans athletes who won the gold and bronze medal in 1968 Mexico Olympics. They wore black socks with no shoes to symbolize black poverty and black gloves with raised clenched fist to represent black power. The International Olympic Association held these two athletes, Carlos and Smith, guilty of violating the Olympic spirit by making a political statement. Their medals were taken back. They are subjected to lot of criticism when they went back home. This was a clear platform given to them. By the Olympic game and have given them opportunity to bring their problems in the eyes of the international association presenting over there and to end their racist regime in USA. Now, regional. In Belgium, people who live in different regions speak different languages. There are linguistic differences, religious and caste. In Sri Lanka, there are both linguistic as well as religious differences existing. In countries like India, we have caste difference. The combination of politics and social division is very dangerous. Democracy involves competition amongst various political parties. Political party is the backbone of a democracy. Their competitions are likely to divide any society. If they start competing in terms of some existing social division, it can make social division into political division and lead to conflict, violence, or even disintegration or division of a country. Hence, politics and social division must not be allowed to mix. One such example is the formation of the Bahujan Samaj Party in India is on the lines of caste. So that particular political party have made a dividing line between the other political party and have gathered support of that particular community, the Dalit community, in the favor of the party. So this kind of approach taken by the political party divides the people on the basis of their social diversity. So expression of social division into politics leads to both positive and negative impact. Political competition along religious ending ethnic lines led to disintegration of Yugoslavia into six independent countries. Social division affect voting in most countries. Now, there are three determinants that are important to understand the politics of social division. These are, first, it depends on how political leaders raise the demands of any community. The outcome of politics of social division depends on how the political leaders raise the demands of different social groups. It is easier to accommodate demands of that within the constitutional framework and are not at the cost of another community. The demand of only Sinhala was at the cost of the interest and identity of Tamil community in Sri Lanka, in such a way that these could not be accommodated within a single community. So this is the first one, that how people, how the political leaders raise the demands of any community. Now, first one which we have talked about, how it depends on how political, how people perceive their identities, whether they see it in single or with the community in which it is living, or person perceives his identity not based on his particular own single identity or a community, but for the country as a whole. For example, if I say that I am Miss Alka Dubey, so this is my one personal identity. If I talk of myself belonging to a society in which I am living in, that I am a teacher, then I am grouping myself into the community of a teacher. When I talk about that I am an Indian, so this is a bigger perspective of mine. So this is what is meant by this, that how people perceive their identity. This is one of the important determinant of the social division in politics. Second one I have already talked about, that how political leaders raise the demand of any particular community. Third one, how the government responds to such demands of the various social groups. Whether the government accommodates all the social diversities and work towards the betterment of all or not. For example, if we talk about that when India got its independence, the constitution makers were aware of the differences that were existing in India, as a result of which many provisions in the constitution were written in favor of the marginalized section of the society to uplift their position in the society and to ensure equality in the society. So this is how the social differences, if expressed politically and rationally in the government, it is for the benefit of the society at a large. Expression of various kinds of social division in politics reduced their intensity and leads to strengthening of a democracy. Democracy is the best way to fight for recognition and also to accommodate diversity in a politics. Now, moving towards the civil rights movement in US. The civil rights movement in US was started by Martin Luther King Jr. This movement emerged in 1954 and lasted till 1968. It was a set of events that aimed at abolishing racial discrimination against African Americans living in America. This movement practiced non-violent methods against racially discriminatory laws and practices of the US government. after the failure of the civil rights movement in US, the black power movement started. This movement came into existence in 1986 and lasted till 1975. It was militant and racial movement. It advocated even violence to end racism in US. So these are the two movements that aimed at removing the racial discrimination and accommodating the differences in a US society. Now, assignments that has to be done related to this chapter are as follows. Discuss the origin of social differences. What is the difference between overlapping and cross-cutting social differences? Explain giving example. Define homogeneous and heterogeneous society. Number four, how did Tommy Smith and John Carlos try to draw international attention to racial discrimination in United States at the time of Olympics held at Mexico City in 1968? Do all social differences lead to social division? Explain with an example. Politics and social division must not be allowed to mix. Substantiate this statement with your argument. Here you have to write about the impact of the politics of social division. Students, this chapter, chapter 3, Democracy and Diversity, will not be evaluated in the board exam. This is an introduction to chapter 4, and this is also going to be evaluated in the PA exams. In the next session, we will have a discussion about chapter 4, Gender, Religion, Caste. Om Namah Shivaya.